Hello, the old year 2023 is on its last day. A new 2024 is on its way. May it be a good one for you. It has been very busy here. So this video is largely what we recorded last year, broadcasting it again, and it is about blessing, leaving the old year in blessing and entering the new year in blessing. May God bless you and may you be a blessing to those around you. It is so good you connect here. Let's together draw strength and inspiration for the time ahead, now in worship of God.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
From the very beginning, the Word was with God.
All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. But what has come into being in him was life.
And the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory in the highest.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory in the highest.
To God be glory forever.
To God be glory forever.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, amen. Alleluia, amen.
Let us pray. Eternal God, we greet you. Hallowed be your name. Early in the year, early in the week, on this day, we pause to praise your glory. Renew us in body, mind and soul at the dawn of a new year. Open our inner eyes, just as the sun scatters the darkness of the night. Unlock our lives from habits no longer fit for this day. Set us free, like the birds in the sky, to begin a new journey. Restore our lives within creation and make justice flow continuously as a mighty river. We thank you for the gift of this day, a new day to live, to praise you, our eternal God. Amen.
I'm looking forward to the future. I have always thought looking into the future was like looking forward, dodging the obstacles in the way, eyes open, alert. When I'm out in the hills, I never see someone not walking forwards, their eyes looking out at what's coming. But then I learned that not everyone thinks the future is ahead and walking equals looking forward. In the Hebrew language, the future is behind us, because no one has eyes in the back of their head and no one can predict the future. In contrast, everyone can know what happened in the past. In Hebrew culture, the future is the big unknown. We have no eyes for it. So in Hebrew, we stumble backwards into the future. We are surprised by obstacles we bump into. Does that feel familiar to you? Are our lives as hazardous as hill walking backwards? Well, some may quote last year's surprise events for proof. I, on my part, am sure I have no eyes in the back of my head. And I sometimes stumble, even walking forward. So I always need trust and hope. Now let's reconnect with Mary and Joseph where we left off, at the point where Mary thought deeply and the shepherds went away from the stable praising God. A week later, when the time came for the baby to be circumcised, he was named Jesus, the name which the angel had given him before he had been conceived.
Luke chapter 2, verses 21 to 38. The time came for Joseph and Mary to perform the ceremony of purification, as the law of Moses commanded. So they took the child to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, as it is written in the law of the Lord. Every firstborn male is to be dedicated to the Lord. They also went to offer a sacrifice of a pair of doves or two young pigeons, as required by the law of the Lord.
At that time there was a man named Simeon, living in Jerusalem. He was a good, God-fearing man, and was waiting for Israel to be saved. The Holy Spirit was with him, and assured him that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's promised Messiah. Led by the Spirit, Simeon went into the temple.
When the parents brought the child Jesus into the temple to do for him what the Lord required, Simeon took the child in his arms and gave thanks to God.
Now, Lord, you have kept your promise, and you may let your servant go in peace. And with my own eyes I have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light to reveal your will to the Gentiles, and bring glory to your people Israel.
The child's father and mother were amazed at the things Simeon said about him. Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "This child is chosen by God for the destruction and the salvation of many in Israel. He will be a sign from God, which many people will speak against, and so reveal their secret thoughts. And sorrow, like a sharp sword, will break your own heart."
There was a very old prophet, a widow named Anna, daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She had been married for only 7 years, and was now 84 years old. She never left the temple. Day and night she worshipped God, fasting and praying.
That very same hour, she arrived and gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were waiting for God to set Jerusalem free.
On the hill of Calvary. breathe is last and I give in for the good of alone. And he's here when we call him, bringing health and love and laughter to life now and ever after, for the good of alone. In a garden just at dawn, near the grave,
the true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world.
The Word was in the world.
And though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him.
He came to what was his own, and his own did not receive him.
But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, children born not of natural descent, nor of human flesh or human will, but born of God.
For most of the years of my life, the new year has begun with a blessing. It would be spoken just after midnight by my father in Gaelic, followed by the same words in English for the rest of us, and it's remained an important and loved thing for us all. I wanted to share it in our service today, a blessing of the new year. And here is read by my sister for my niece's wedding.
Hey, Beannachadh an la uair, na do thuradh chun roimhe riamh, is an go Beannachadh do ghnùis, thug ùine seo chun a ghi, Beannachadh uise chun mo chúil, Beannachadh mo chúil na ghi, Beannachadh mi mo nápi, Beannachadh mo nápi mi. Chéad tafar chun se crí a ghlan, na leic a seal do thuala mi. Beannachadh mo ghnùis mo bhéin, is Beannachadh mo neachas mo ní.
That same power that's made the world is the power that lives in me. So I can shine for you, 'cause you sent your fire. I can live each day, 'cause you live in me. I can shout for I can shine for you.
so we begin a new year, 2023. God bless to us the new day never granted to us before, as it said in the blessing. What will you do with this year never granted to you before? It's a completely new one, as is each day when it comes. It may look like all the other years or all the other days, but it's new and fresh and given to us by God for our using. And so the answer comes in the same words that we heard. It is to bless your own presence, God, that this year and this day are given to us. It's the question from the Catechism, actually. The chief end of man, as they say, is to glorify God. Each day that's given to us is for us to do something beautiful for God. But what will that be? How will you glorify God? How will you honour God in the year of our Lord, which is 2023? And perhaps the simple answers, and who needs complicated answers when simple ones will do, they're there in the rest of the prayer. Blessing all that we see, blessing our neighbours, and praying for that blessing to be returned, blessing our families and our work, and remaining in God's presence, in God's sight, that not just our eye, but also our heart will remain clean. This New Year blessing is recorded in the Carmina Gaelica from my own family, among others. It was extensively used in the Highlands and probably still is. And I've always loved the fact that the first thing that happened for us in the new year was that we committed it to God and in a blessing. But actually, that's just the start. And it's what happens after that makes the difference. Because it's not much use having pious rituals and uttering beautiful blessings if you then neglect to keep your eye and your heart clear as the day and the year go on. Prayer sends us in the right direction, but we have to let it transform us. A week after Jesus was born, he was circumcised, according to the practice still continuing. That would have been in the house in Bethlehem. And then after 6 weeks, he's presented in the temple in Jerusalem to complete the purification rites after childbirth. Simeon and Anna are waiting, knowing that finally this is the child who will change the world. They offer blessing and thanksgiving and prophecy. And immediately, it's about the whole world, the people of Israel and the rest of the people too, Jews and Gentiles or non-Jews. This child will bring light and salvation for all. And it's two older people, a man and a woman, faithfully following God, who are given the blessing of Jesus and the vision for the world. We don't actually hear of any priests or officials who might have performed ceremonies, just the two who saw Jesus and were open to what was going on, along with the shepherds a few weeks before, and perhaps anyone else in Bethlehem who was alert and listening to God and these strange new things. It's unlikely the wise men would have appeared by now, because afterwards Joseph and Mary had to flee and they certainly wouldn't be visiting Jerusalem. But early on, in Jesus' first year, he was presented in the temple, presented to God. And there he was blessed by strangers. The blessing of the new year. What will this year hold for you? What will you do with this new year given to you by God? Our other reading that we're hearing in bits is from the Gospel of John. And it tells us what God will do this new year as every year. God becomes a human being, lives among us, moves into the neighbourhood, says the Message translation. God moving in among us, into our neighbourhood here, with us. It's what that word means that we use for God at Christmas, but actually neglect the rest of the year. Emmanuel, God with us. And we have to think of how it happened. Not the palace, not the luxury, not even the security. God moves needily into the neighbourhood, dependent on others to survive. No expensive mortgage, no luxury townhouse, no mod cons, barely the basics. God needs our help. That's God's way. But when God comes to us, it isn't blessing. God comes full of grace and truth, as a light shining in the darkness that the darkness has and can and will never put out. Out of the fullness of his grace, he's blessed us all, giving us one blessing after another. We receive God's blessing as we help one another. Anna and Simeon are examples of that. Blessed to me my eye. May my eye bless all it sees. I will bless my neighbour. May my neighbour bless me. We're in it together, dependent on one another. And that's how it should be and needs to be in churches as everywhere else. It's a new year, never granted to us before. And it is to bless God's own presence that God has given us this time. God has come to us, has moved in among us. But it's a needy God, a refugee God, who needs our help. What will you do with this new year, never granted to you before? It's not so much about traditional resolutions, eat less, exercise more, that kind of thing, as about perhaps an attitude, a resolve, rather than resolution. Will I seek God in this year, the God who has moved in among us? Do I take that blessing seriously, that we're here to honour God? Will I make my life a force for good in the world? Or are there other values and principles and goals which are for me more important and may override what God's role is? What will I do? God's blessing is there in God's presence with us, but God needs us to make a difference. Who will you be in this new year? What will you do? What do you need? And who will go with you? Let's think about these things for a while, and then we'll move into prayer. First, some music.
I invite you to prayer guided by my words. When you hear my words, may your will be done, you can all join in, and your kingdom come. Let's pray. At the beginning of this year, we take time to be silent in the presence of God and to offer our hopes and our fears for the year ahead. May your will be done, and your kingdom come. We give thanks for all that has been good this past year, where there have been moves towards peace, where freedom and justice have increased, where poverty has lessened, and dreams made reality. But in sorrow we hold before you those places where there is no peace, where there is no freedom and little justice, where poverty has increased and dreams not been dashed. May your will be done and your kingdom come. We thank you for all that has been good in our own lives, where there has been joy and achievement and satisfaction and good news. Where last year was hard and painful, and sometimes we felt your presence and sometimes you seemed far from us, we give all that we are and have been to you, knowing that you do never leave us. And we pray that this year you will bless us. May your will be done and your kingdom come. We pray for those who fear this new year, who have been given or are expecting bad news, who await struggle or loss, or who must continue their journey bereaved of those they love. We pray for those who fear a coming darkness, a descent into illness or anxiety or addiction. But we also pray for those who look forward in the new year to birth or marriage or new opportunities. May your will be done and your kingdom come. In silence now, we name before you those for whom we want to pray today. Into your hands, O God, we place the future, and use us for your glory. And we continue in prayer as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
The Word became a human being and lived among us.
And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Out of the fullness of his grace, he has blessed us all, giving us one blessing after another.
God gave the law through Moses, but grace and truth came through Jesus Christ.
No one has ever seen God.
It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known.
Thank you.
So fresh the light, so new the day,
so clean the moment.
Shape it, God, with us.
So hopeful the year,
so expectant the time,
so long the journey.
Shape it, God, with us.
So filled the promise,
so believable the story,
so keen the people.
Shape it, God, with us.
May all peace start with you,
and all justice be blessed here.
May we travel in your name,
and find you everywhere.
May grace guide us,
and love hold us all.
So short the beginning,
so thin the opportunity,
so fragile the journey.
Shape it, God, with us.
And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with us, with you all, in this new year and always. Amen.
Amen.